For a wet system setup, you'll want to have a few components available to help you select an installation point for your soft plumed nozzle. Gather the pieces and hand tighten an assembly of the solenoids in their brackets and thread in their appropriate filters. Add the fuel feed line to the filter on the fuel solenoid. Next, thread in the fuel and nitrous delivery hoses that will connect to the nozzle, along with a set of jets. Now you'll have a temporary plumbing assembly that will help you determine a number of variable mounting options.
Place the temporary plumbing assembly under the hood and look around for the best point to introduce the soft plume nozzle. For a single wet fogger kit, the nozzle needs to install in the intake duct between the air cleaner assembly and the throttle body unit where the throttle lever exists. While you decide on an entry point, consider that the nozzle and its hoses will most likely need to be inserted sideways rather than straight down because of hood clearance issues if the hoses were sticking up. At the same time you're deciding on a nozzle placement, figure out the best mounting positions for your solenoids. Wherever you decide for the nitrous solenoid, be sure the nitrous line from the bottle will be able to reach the entry point of the solenoid filter. The same goes for the additional fuel feed line to the fuel solenoid. Look for an existing bolt for each solenoid bracket, or if it works better, consider adding a bolt or an adapter bracket to an unused and pre-threaded hole along the engine. When you've found a good spot for the nozzle and solenoids, we can get to the actual installation of the nozzle. Start by removing the intake duct from between the throttle body and the air cleaner assembly. As mentioned before, look for the nozzle mounting collar and nut that was included in your kit. As you decide on an entry point for the nozzle, keep in mind that you'll need to be able to physically reach into the intake tube to install the mounting collar inside the duct, and you'll also need to hold the collar steady with a tool while you tighten the nut from the outside. With that said, drill a 7/16 inch hole into the inlet duct while it's removed from the vehicle. Clean out any shavings with air or a vacuum and make sure the edges are smooth. As just described, slide the collar in place from inside the tube and then hold the collar with a tool from the inside as you tighten the nut from the outside. With the collar installed, reassemble your intake duct or tube assembly and tighten everything properly so we can install the nozzle into the mounting collar. The nozzle will thread into place and needs two things for a proper install. The first is to mark the nozzle in a place that will face forward in the direction that it will spray. Before installing, look at the exit direction of the fuel and nitrous from the nozzle and directly above it, etch a mark in the exposed area of the nozzle so that as you thread it in, you'll know where to set the final pointing direction of the spray. The second thing you'll need to do is seal the threads of the nozzle. Do not use Teflon tape to seal the threads. Pieces can break off and enter your intake stream, potentially causing severe engine damage. Instead, use a Teflon paste or a plumbing pipe thread sealant that contains PTFE, which is a Teflon derivative. With a thin, even amount of sealant on the threads, spin the nozzle into the mounting collar you installed in your intake duct or tube. Don't let the nozzle bottom out in the collar. When spinning it by hand, if it feels like it's tightening to a stop, spin just slightly backwards until the mark that you made on the nozzle points directly towards the throttle body of the engine. The nozzle should feel secure, but may still be a bit loose in the threads. Remember, the Teflon paste needs a bit of time to solidify for the most secure fit.